Now they have told us to find the values of ICQ and VCQ for different values of beta. So what we can do, we can change the value of beta to 50, we can change the value of beta to 150 and find the value of IBQ. Once you know IBQ, you can find ICQ and VCQ. So what I have done, I have substituted the values of beta as 50 and 150, and I have got the values of ICQ and VCQ, which is shown in the table. Over here, you can see for the value of beta 50, you got IBQ 35.5, 35.9, ICQ 1.8, 1.83, and 5.67. Now, when you look at the entire diagram, for 150, you got 15.5 microampere, ICQ 2.32, IEQ 2.34, and VCEQ 4.4 volts. Now, the units are written in the bracket on at the top. Now, when you look at the table, what you can say? For the change in beta, 3 is to 1 change in the beta, that is ratio between 50 and 150 is 3 is to 1. Collector current and the collector emitter voltage, that is VCEQ, they are changing by just 1.29 is to 1%, whereas in fixed bias, this ratio was very large, right? So hence we can predict that the voltage divider biasing is stable bias. Again, they have mentioned that when the circuit contains an emitter resistor, what do you mean by that? You have the voltage divider circuit R1 and R2 that can bias the transistor in active region using the resistor values in low kilo ohms. So the resistance value required for bias here is low kilo ohms, whereas in fixed bias, you require very large values of the biasing resistor. Single resistor biasing requires mega ohms, we can say, right? Therefore, the change in ICQ and VCEQ with the change in beta has been reduced compared to fixed bias when you look at these values, right? This means that including the emitter resistor in the circuit, it helps to stabilize the Q point for the variation in beta. That is, we are changing the value of beta, but the Q point is more stable in this case. One more thing we can say, if the value of RTH is very small, then R1 and R2 are small, and therefore excessive power will be dissipated in these resistors, right? So in order to avoid this, we can have a bias stable circuit for which we have RTH value as 10% of the RE value. You can say RTH is 0.1 1 plus beta times RE. So this circuit we require in the design problems where we need to find the value of R1 and R2 and RE value is specified in the question. So in that case, we need to use this relation. RTH is 0.1 times, that is 10% of the value of RE for the bias stable case.